Our lecturer for today is Jasfer Crisan E. Ventura, graduate of the University of the Philippines, BS Education, major in Mathematics, minor in Physics, teacher 2 at Jose Abad Santos High School, and lecturer 2 at Universidad de Manila.
Okay, for today's video, our objective is to illustrate quadratic equations. But how can we illustrate quadratic equations kung hindi natin alam kung ano nga ba ang quadratic equations in the first place? Okay, so to define what quadratic equations are, a quadratic equation is a second degree polynomial equation that can be written in standard form, which is ax squared plus bx plus c equals 0, wherein your a, b, and c are real numbers and a can never be equal to 0. So, one of you might ask, why is it important that a can never be equal to 0? So, para mas maintindihan natin kung bakit nga ba important na hindi maging equal si a sa 0, eh, tignan natin yung case na yun. If a is equal to 0, what will happen to our equation? The term ax squared will be eliminated from the general form, or rather the standard form of our equation, thus resulting to an equation bx plus c equals 0. And obviously, this is no longer a quadratic equation, but it is just a linear equation. Okay, for you to better grasp the lesson, it is better for us to have examples of quadratic equations. Now, for our first example, let's say our equation is 3x squared plus 4x plus 15 equals 0. Why? Bakit natin masasabi na this is actually a quadratic equation? Because you can see here the quadratic term ax squared, wherein in this example, it is 3x squared. And the variable x only has two exponents, which are positive 2 and 1. Hindi tayo nakakakita ng negative exponents ng x. So therefore, obviously, this first example is indeed a quadratic equation. Second one, x squared over 3 plus x over 4 minus 25 equals 0. This is also an example of a quadratic equation because still, andito naman yung term natin na ax squared, nandito din naman si bx, nandito din naman si c, and yeah, this is still a quadratic equation. The third, let's have another one. Let's say you have 0.7 minus 0.2x plus 2.5x squared equals 0. So kung mapapansin po natin, hindi naman siya kagaya nung unang dalawa na examples natin. Nasa dulo si 2.5x squared, nasa dulo yung quadratic term natin. And it should not be a problem for us because we can actually rewrite this equation in another way later on para na, at mas magigets nyo kung bakit nga importante na maisulat natin yung ating quadratic equation in its standard form. Okay, so para mas magets natin kung ano nga ba ang mga quadratic equations, let's now give some non-examples of quadratic equations. So for the first one, let's say you have negative 4x cubed plus 2x squared plus 3 equals 0. So, ang tanong, bakit nga ba hindi ito example ng quadratic equation? Dahil po, makakakita tayo dito ng term na kung saan yung exponent ni x is already 3. And it is stated in the definition of our quadratic equation na hindi pa pwedeng mas malaki pa sa 2 yung maging exponent ni variable x. Another non-example would be x raised to negative 2 minus 4x plus 5 equals 0. Yes, may nakikita po tayong xi exponent ni x dito na 2, but it's not positive 2. So therefore, just by looking at this term, wherein your exponent is negative 2, hindi na natin siya pwedeng makonsider na quadratic equation dahil nga kailangan positive 2 yung exponent natin. Last, square root of x plus 2x minus 8 equals 0. Dito, na we can see that our variable x is inside the radical symbol square root. And hindi din po pwede na maging, na magkaroon tayo ng variable x under the radical symbol, making this example a non-quadratic equation. Okay, so now we need to determine the values of a, b, and c. Bakit po? Kasi nga, later on, when we will be solving our quadratic equations, these values are actually very significant. Bakit po? Kasi hindi nyo magagamit yung mga methods na yun kung hindi natin alam kung ano yung values ng A, B, and C. Okay? So, to do that, let's look at our examples earlier. Let's write again the standard form of our quadratic equation, which is ax squared plus bx plus c equals 0. So, obviously, dapat ang maging mindset natin, maisulat natin yung ating quadratic equation in this form na kung saan nauuna yung quadratic term natin, next is our linear term, third is the constant term, equals 0. Very important na dapat naka-equal siya sa 0 lagi. So for our first example, we have 3x squared plus 4x plus 15 equals 0. Paano makukuha yung values ng A, B, and C? Si A po, it's just the numerical coefficient of the term x squared. So pag sinabi natin numerical coefficient, yun po yung katabing number niya. And here, in this example, A is actually, obviously, positive 3. Kasi yung 3 na yan, yung katabi nung x squared natin. And for your b, b is actually the numerical coefficient of our term x. So kung makakita ka na dyan ng x, yung value ng b natin ay yung katabi niyang number, which is positive 4. As for your c, c is actually the lone number or yung ating constant term na wala siyang katabi dapat na x squared or even katabing x. And in this case, it is positive 15. So for number 1, the values of A, B, and C are positive 3, 4, and 15 respectively. Another example, our second example earlier, which is x squared over 3 plus x over 4 minus 25 equals 0. So to get the values of A, B, and C, we're just looking at the numbers, or rather the coefficients, the numerical coefficients of the terms x squared and x. For your a, a is the numerical coefficient of x squared. And in this example, the numerical coefficient of x squared over 3 is positive 1/3. For your b, b is actually equal to positive 1/4. Why? Because 1/4 is the numerical coefficient of the variable x. And C is simply negative 25 because it's the lone number or the constant term. For our third example, it's not similar to our first two examples because the third one is not written in standard form. Pero pwede naman po nating isulat yun ng naka-standard form. Paano? By simply rearranging our terms. So let's write first 2.5x squared because this one is the quadratic term. Second one is the negative 0.2x term. And the last one is the constant term or the lone number, which is plus 0.7, and then equate it to 0. Now, since nakasulat na siya ng standard form, madali na nating makukuha kung ano yung values ng A, B, and C. A here is 2.5. B here is negative 0.2. And C is equal to 0.7. Now you know how to get or determine the values of A, B, and C. And to recap all the things that we've learned today, we've just illustrated quadratic equations. What are quadratic equations? Quadratic equations are second degree polynomial equations that can be written in standard form, ax squared plus bx plus c equals 0. And a, b, and c are real numbers wherein your a can never be equal to 0. In our upcoming lessons, we will now be solving quadratic equations.
Hi! Kung sa tingin ninyo kami nakakatulong sa inyong pag-aaral bilang estudyante at kung kami nakakatulong sa inyo bilang mga magulang at mga guro, please do subscribe to our channel. We wanted to reach as many as possible. And in exchange, we will commit ourselves, our time, and little resources to create more videos na makatutulong para sa kinabukasan at maayos at mabisang pag-aaral ng bawat estudyante sa ating bansa.